Hello, I am Alisha Mallik. I have came to the screen of Shiro Vision with some new pieces of news for you. India reports 38,667 new COVID-19 cases, 478 deaths in 24 hours. India reported 38,667 new COVID-19 cases on Saturday, with 478 people succumbing to the infection in the last 24 hours, according to data shared by Union Health Ministry. Among all the states, Kerala reported the highest COVID-19 cases. After that, followed by Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. This five states accounted for 84.02% of the daily new cases reported on Sunday, with Kerala alone responsible for 52.89% of the fresh infections. A total of 35,743 patients recovered during the last 24 hours. The recovery rate further increased to 97.45%, while the weekly positivity rate continued to remain below 5%. A total of 63,80,937 vaccine doses were administered in the last 24 hours, which brings the total tally of doses administered. Taliban near Kabul siege 18 of 24 provinces as Afghan government says we stand firm. Taliban have seized Afghanistan's second and third biggest cities as resistance from government forces fails, stoking fears that an assault on the capital, Kabul, would be just days away. With every passing day, the important cities of Afghanistan have been falling into the hands of Taliban. A government official confirmed that Kandahar, the economic hub of the south, is now under Taliban control. The provinces that have fallen are Jaranj, Shevargan, Saripul, Gunduz, Talukan, Aibak, Farha, Puli Kumri, Farizabad, Ghazni, Herat, Kandahar, Lakshargah, Kualaino, Firuzko, Pulialam, Terakot, Kualat. With pressure mounting on Afghan government and forces as Taliban close in, there are reports that the president of Afghanistan, Ashraf Ghani, may address the nation. Sources said that the Ashraf Ghani is likely to address the country on Saturday to inform them about the fate of its government. Afghan First Vice President Amrullah Saleh said he was proud of the country's armed force. It was decided with conviction and resolve that we stand firm against Taliban terrorists and do everything to strengthen the national resistance by all means and ways, create. He tweeted after a national security meeting chaired by President Ashraf Ghani. The fighting has raised fears of a refugee crisis and a rollback of gains in human rights since the Taliban were ousted. Allies are constantly consulting on the situation of Afghanistan, the official said, adding that Stoltenberg was in regular contact with allies and the Afghan authorities. NATO is monitoring the security situation very closely. We continue to coordinate with the Afghan authorities and the rest of the international community, the official said. Rapid Taliban conquest across Afghanistan led the Biden administration on Friday to rush 3,000 fresh troops to the Kabul airport to help with the partial evacuation of the U.S. embassy in the capital and send 1,000 more to the region to be on standby and speedy alert for Afghans who work with the American military. The Taliban completed their sweep of the country south on Friday as they took 4 prominent provincial capitals in a lightning offensive that is gradually encircling Kabul, just weeks before the U.S. is set to officially end its 2-decade war. Priya Kapoor and Karan Bulani to get married on August 14 at Anil Kapoor's Juhu home. Anil Kapoor and Sunita Kapoor's daughter and producer Riya Kapoor and her longtime boyfriend Karan Bulani are getting married in an intimate ceremony at the Kapoor's Juhu bungalow on August 14, 2021. The ceremony is expected to be private affair with only the families and the couple's close friends in attendance. Sources tell India Today that the ceremony is likely to be a 2-3-day affair. However, an official spokesperson for the Kapoor family is yet to confirm the same. Ria and Karan been in a relationship for the first 13 years. Karan Bolani is a filmmaker who was credited with many ad commercials. He has also assisted in films like Aisha produced by Ria Kapoor and Makeup Set. Sonam Kapoor flew down to Mumbai in July after a year in London. Her husband Anand Ahuja is also in Mumbai at the moment. Ria and Karan's wedding is expected to take place today, August 14. The two are tying the knot in a khushbu ceremony at the couple's June home.
Zero Vision. Shabar Shati, Shabar Pashi. Zero Vision.
Zero Vision aaj Kolkata তথা গ্রাম বাংলার পশ্চিমবঙ্গের সাধারণ মানুষের পাশে এসে দাঁড়িয়েছে। জিরো ভিশন সবার সাথে সবার পাশে, আপনারাও পারেন জিরো ভিশনের মতন সবার পাশে এসে দাঁড়াতে। আসুন না, সাহায্যের হাত বাড়িয়ে দিই। আপনারা যদি সাহায্য করতে চান, তলার এই নাম্বারগুলোর সাথে যোগাযোগ করতে পারেন। প্রত্যেকটাই আমাদের জিরো ভিশন সংস্থার নাম্বার। ভালো থাকুন, সুস্থ থাকুন।
That's it for today for me and my team. Thank you for watching. Please stay safe and stay at home. If you like our channel, please do subscribe, like, share and comment. Thank you.